السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Wanna welcome everyone back to the Qalam Hangout where we're trying to answer your questions about the month of Ramadan, 30 days, 30 questions. So we had a very interesting question submitted to us, and that was, how old does a person have to be before they start fasting? When should someone start fasting, or when should a child be motivated to start fasting? So again, I'm going to split the answer up into a couple of different parts. The first thing is, when is someone required fard, when are they required to start fasting? So the answer to that question is, when somebody reaches the age of maturity, somebody hits, you know, puberty, then at that point in time it becomes obligatory, mandatory, fard on them to start fasting. That, and how do you exactly distinguish that? Then that can be distinguished through the physical signs. If a young, you know, woman starts to experience menses, or a young brother experiences certain physical signs, or even the growth of facial hair and things like that, then that basically is the onset of the age of maturity in Islam. At the same time, the fuqaha, the scholars of Islam, have said that 15 is the cutoff age. So even if somebody has not experienced any of the physical signs of reaching the age of maturity by the age of 15, after 15 it will be mandatory without question on a person to start fasting. But usually the case is that people, you know, young brothers and sisters are experiencing maturity a lot sooner, a lot before, you know, much before that, as early as 10, 11, 12 years of age, they're experiencing maturity, and it is mandatory on them to start fasting. And that's something we have to take into consideration and we have to take into account. So we have to stop, you know, we have to, of course, motivate them and encourage them and support them. But at the same time, we have to make sure that we're not babying them in an unhealthy way, where we're giving them excuses to not perform their fara'id, their obligations, because that could become a spiritual crutch for them later on in life. So that's the answer about when it's mandatory. When is it recommended? Then that again will be up to the better judgment of the parents. We can do qiyas from, we can basically, you know, extrapolate and also draw a parallel to the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ where he talked about prayer. Again, prayer becomes mandatory on a person at the same age fasting becomes mandatory. But the Prophet ﷺ said, start encouraging. Start, you know, praying with your kids as early as 7 years of age. And at the age of 10, then start having consequences for them not praying. You're not praying? All right, the video games are being taken away. You're not praying? All right, you're not going out to play. No pray, no play, right? And start to create some level of consequences, some responsibility about daily prayers. My recommendation from my own experience of my younger siblings, kids in my community, and now my own children as well, I would give the same recommendation. That while, let's just say fasting will become mandatory on a child when they reach the age of 12, I would recommend that maybe as early as 7 or 8. I know it's the summertime right now, so it's a little difficult. So that's why I'm saying the parents have to practice some good judgment there. They know what's good for their child and what their child is capable of. At the same time, you don't want to torture the child and force them to fast, and, you know, beating them and hitting them, astaghfirullah, is already something that's very, very bad and reprehensible. So you don't want to abuse, not even emotionally abuse the child into fasting. But start encouraging them. Maybe have like a special gift for them. There'll be a little get-together at iftar. And maybe as early as 8, 10 years old, encourage them to start experiencing some fasting, you know, a couple of times during the month of Ramadan, so that they start to develop the good habit. So when 12 comes around, 13 comes around, 15 comes around, they don't all of a sudden have to start fasting the entire 30 days. And they're like, whoa, where's this coming from? What's going on? And at the same time, they're older and more mature, and sometimes parents get pushback from the kids at that time, and then they don't really know what to do with the situation. So if you create a good environment for fasting, you know, create some excitement for them about fasting whenever they fast, have a little get-together for iftar, give them a gift, reward them, incentivize fasting for them. These are all good methods of encouraging and teaching good habits to our children. So that's a little bit about when is it mandatory to fast, and then when is it recommended to have a child start fasting. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the month of Ramadan a month of blessing for us, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our fasts and all our worship during this blessed month. Jazakumullah khairan. This was the Qalam Hangout from Qalam Institute. And I want to remind you all, inshallah, if you got any questions you'd like answered, then feel free to send them in to us. Don't hesitate. You can tweet them to us with the hashtag Qalam Hangout. You can leave the questions on our Facebook page. You can also email the questions to us. Just remember to put in the subject line, Qalam Hangout, and we'll try to get to as many of your questions as we can. Until next time, Jazakumullahu Khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.